This is the game I really wanted to try from the moment I saw it. What's up, everybody? Welcome to the Life of a Board Gamer. My name is Daniel, and today we are going to check out BOONLAKE, a present I got from Secret Santa on a Boardgame Geek, and I finally got to play it a little bit and try it out. Let's get down to the table, let me show you what you get inside this box, and then we'll talk some more about it. Okay, let's check out BOONLAKE. Now, first of all, a rule book, and there is a lot of things to read in here. Now, this game, by all means, is not hard, but there is so much going on. First few turns, you will be completely lost, wondering what's happening, but once you get a hang of it, it goes really nicely. So yeah, each of the players will get the components in their color. So you will get a bunch of little dudes, you will get some houses, you will get some cows, you will have these little dudes to play on the board. This is like a worker placement game. Then you will have these small houses and bigger houses that you can put on the board. All kinds of different tokens to track different things, little cows that you can also put on the board and earn you some points. But yeah, each player will get their own tokens, and then they will put them on the board and score points and do a bunch of different things. So you also get coins, of course, because you need to have something to pay your stuff with, and there's also currency. These vases are also a currency, some of a sort, and then there's these technologies on the board that you will use these tokens to activate and deactivate for each turn, that I'll show you in a second. Now, the interesting thing is these tiles, and you will use one per player, and as you can see, there is like a gazillion different combinations of tiles, and you will use only, in a four-player game, you will use only four, so the possibilities and combinations are basically endless, and the great thing about these tiles is you will use them at the start of the game to define your endgame scoring, which is super hard because you don't really know what everybody else is going to pick, and you are just picking what you want to score, but you have to score what others also put on the board. It is a lot of things is going on in here, a lot of things. Now, you get a bunch of cards. I will not show you all of them. I'll just take a few of these cards. So basically, these cards tell you depending which action you take, which we will talk in a second, but once you decide to play one of these cards are all different. There are some characters, there are some buildings, some of them are just one-time use, some of them are like endgame scoring, and if they have sun over here, you need to be sure to pick up the correct token, and you will be picking one of these actions to play each turn, and you need to be sure that you picked up the one showing the same symbol as the card, so you can play it, and you have to pay their cost, and then you move on a track or something. So there's all kinds of different cards in here. Some of them will give you like a petting zoo, which will put your cows for one less, stuff like that. And as you can see, there is a gazillion cards in here, a lot of cards, like a full stack of cards that you will not go through for one game, which I really, really like. Even though they do repeat with a little bit of changes, but overall, this is a really big deck of various things that are going on. If I'm not mistaken, this is a solo module. I haven't played with this one. I just played the base game, but I presume this is the solo module for the game. And then we have this river thing, and this is the beauty, and all of your actions will be put randomly here like so. Let's say, for example, at the start of the game you did it like this, and depending which thing you choose, which of these actions you choose, that's how much movement you can do on the river. And that is important because moving on the river basically pushes you to the end game scoring and the end of the game. And so basically the players are controlling when the game is going to end, or how the game is going to last, how long or how fast is going to be over. And basically, once you pick one of these tiles, you will do some actions. Let's say, for example, I pick this one, then I can do some stuff, other players can do some stuff, or different things, and you can play or discard card for gold, or play a card that has like a moon symbol on it. And Once I did that, I will move two spaces on the river track up to two spaces. All of these will switch over here up, and this one will go down on the bottom, because if anybody after me, immediately after me, wants to use it, they will have to pay 3 victory points. So this makes sure that you don't overplay one action, so that they cycle a little bit more. And all of these actions will give you things to move on the board, to score different points, and this is something really interesting. Now, there is a whole bunch of tokens over here that you will be putting on the board. And some of these tokens have these little cows. So the cows go over here on this board, like fields, and they will score you points. And other has these places for your houses. Over here, if you put a house, you will pay 2 coins, but then you will advance on a track for earning money each turn, which is really good. The second player that comes over here, that can even be you, will have to pay 4. And some of them will just reward you points. This will just give you 2 gold if you go over here, but the other player will get none if they arrive after you. And they are all put randomly on the board. These cows are double-sided. They are really, but all of these other tiles, you don't know what you're gonna get once you pull it. Then you see what it is, and then you have to decide where you're gonna put it on a board, which I will show you in a second. Let's switch and let me show you how the board looks, and then we'll talk about the player boards itself. So these are the player boards, and they are really nice double layered boards. But first, let's talk about the main board. Okay, so we have the main board over here, and the main board consists, as I told you, of this river. And once you go through this river, and once you go over this dam over here, you will do a scoring part, and you will travel over here, and then you will do, once you go over here, you will do another scoring part. And then, depending how many players is playing, if it's a 4-player game, you can go over here, or if it's a 3-to-4-player game, you can go, 1-to-3 players goes over here, I apologize. And then you will go with your ships over here. Then you will, once again, once you pick those actions, you can travel, let's say, up to 4 spaces down the river. You will travel through these spaces. You will get some of these rewards on the spaces that you end on. And the second time you are going, you will go down here. And once you get over here, is the end of the game. And whoever has the most points is the winner. All of these scoring tiles will go over here, so you know which one is yours in different colors. So once you score yours, you will get extra points. So, and over here you will track how much you earn each turn and how many cards you can take out each turn. And this just explains you how everything is scored when it's scoring time, these dams. And then there's all kinds of different areas over here that you can build on. You can put these tiles on, get rewards, and also you will get these production things that I'll show you in a second what they do, these factories, different factories. And yeah, there you can score different sections of these boards throughout the game to give you points and to mess up with other players so they score less and you score more. And the last thing that I want to show you is these player boards. And over here, basically, you will keep all your houses, those little houses and big houses, and all your cows, because once you play them on the board, once you open some of them, you will unlock extra workers that you can use. And over here, you have river, which have a really nice mechanic. You have boats here. You have 2 boats that start on the space with the wood. And depending where you keep them, they will bring you 1 extra of this. But the beauty is you can move them freely from here to anywhere over here, up here. You can move them freely. But if you want to go back, you have to pay coins to go back on some other spaces. So because at the start, you don't have access to all the factories, all the everything. So if you want to build some tiles, do some stuff, you will need to play some cards. You will need to move these ships strategically. And that's really beautifully done. And over here are all the technologies that you can buy, and you can use those tokens to activate and deactivate them. Once you play them, you will just cover them so you know you don't have them for this turn anymore. And as I said, this is really nicely done, double layered board, which comes like opened up, and then you have these stickers that they provided, so don't mess up and throw away these because you will need them. And you just stickered them over here, and I almost was an idiot, and I was like, my god, this is really, and I almost tore them apart. But basically what you do is you just flip them over and glue them on these 2 parts. As you can see, you can kind of open them up, but over here they are glued on these little thingies. And yeah, be careful once you when you are assembling these, because you will punch out some things over here that you need. So don't throw away these. Read the rules very carefully. But yeah, basically that's everything that comes in BOONLAKE. Now let's talk a little bit more about it. Okay, so that was BOONLAKE, and as I already mentioned at the intro of this video, once I first laid my eyes on this game, it kind of clicked with me for some reason. The artwork, the board, the box itself, the components. And I like when you have these player boards where you can do some stuff on there, and once you uncover it, you get some extra things. So I definitely wanted to try this game out. And luckily, my Secret Santa from a Boardgame Geek sent me none other than BOONLAKE. And I thoroughly enjoyed it. This game is awesome. Now, fair warning. Once you start learning this game, when you need to explain this game to other players, they are going to have their brains melt. There is so much going on in here. You have cards, you have your own board, you have the main board, you have these actions that you need to pick. All of these actions do different things. Explain each of those actions. How they are referenced to the cards. What is the cost of the card? What the cards do? You have these tracks for gold, you have these technologies on your board that you can buy, and then you can activate them and you can deactivate them. There's a lot of things going on, and I'm not saying that in a bad way, because the thing is, and it's the beauty of this game, once you played few turns, like three, maybe four, at maximum five turns, and that's like nowhere near the end of the game, you completely understand how the game plays and how it works, and then it's just going through the motions, just going through those, picking those actions, selecting, playing those cards, going down those rivers, collecting stuff, then putting tiles on the board, building buildings, scoring them. Once the scoring happens, once you go over that dam and the scoring happens, and then it's just who can score it the better. The beautiful thing is that you choose your scorings. Once the scoring happens, you choose what you will be scoring at the start of the game, and you put those little components, those little boards, you put them on the main board, and that's how you will be scoring throughout the game. And you will choose on each scoring which of those tiles you will score, either yours or other players' tiles. But as more as you prolong to score some of these tiles, the progressively harder they become to score. So you have to be very careful what you want to go for, because if you decide to not go on some of the, because you can't have everything in the game, and if you decide to not go on some things, like playing cards or maybe putting cattle out there or building buildings, and then the scoring comes and says you have to have five of these and I don't know, stuff like that. As you can see, there's lots of different things you can score in this game. There are lots of different tiles that you will put on the board, so each game will feel completely differently. Just that, picking, what I was trying to say is just picking those tiles at the start of the game, and then trying to, so you try to accommodate your tactic once you see what's there on the board. For the first game, you will just go whatever, because there's lots of things going on, but after a few games, it is just a beautiful, beautiful design, done really, really nicely. I was like, my mind was blown. When I first was explained this game to, because luckily, my friend Slaven also got this game, and he learned it, and he teached me this game. And as he was explaining it to me, I was like I felt my brain melting. But as I said, once you go through a few turns, it just starts clicking, and you go left and right and play your turns super easy. It is wonderful, wonderful game. If you play with somebody that has analysis paralysis like my friend has, I don't know if he's watching this video, maybe he does. He was like super stuck. So be aware, if some players like to analyze more which action will give them the most benefit and everything, this game will last some time. But otherwise, it is super quick. You just go take stuff, do play cards, discard the card, do some things other players do, then something else, or you do also with them, or they just do stuff like that, and you are done. Next turn goes after who knows how many turns, there's the end of the game, final scoring, whoever has the most points is the winner. BOONLAKE is such a wonderful design. It is a game where there is so much thing happening, but it's so easy to understand. that I definitely recommend you check this one out. Don't be afraid to dive into it. There is a lot going on, but once you understand how the game works, and I can't stress that out more. I know I'm repeating myself, but I think that this game will be overlooked by so many players because it looks and feels complicated, but it is not. There is just a lot of things that is going on, but you just take your card, decide what you want to do with it, and go with it, and just play that. So it is an awesome, awesome design that I wholeheartedly recommend you check it out. Give it a chance. It's a great game. Don't overlook it because it looks complicated. It just feels complicated for first few turns. After that, it's just easy sailing down the river. So yeah, that is that. Thank you all for watching. Thank you all for spending time with me on this video. Now, I noticed that most of you that watch these videos of mine are not subscribed, so I would implore you to hit that subscribe button, because that way I will have more subscribers on this channel, and publishers will notice me, and I will have more great games for you to review, so you can see those videos. You know what I'm trying to say. Subscribe. And also, you can check out my Patreon. You can support the channel that way. There's some videos, like mostly gameplay videos, that Slaven and I, or me alone, film. And then I put all of them, the entire series, on my Patreon exclusively just for you guys, and then slowly release them into the wild on the YouTube. And yeah, that is that. Thank you all for watching. Thank you for considering subscribing. And do join me next time when we are going sailing smoothly down the river. And once we see a big dam, we're gonna score some points or whatever. And yeah, that is that. Until next time. Pozdrav. And I must say, I some areas you want to score, areas where you have all of them, like you have to like discard something, you have to one of the best designers that I ever encountered. Oh my god. Stupid. And yeah, it is, this game is the ripping in a video. So classy. I already said in a intro of this video, what a strange pause.